Well, now at noon, we're getting a new look at Dorian's devastation in the Bahamas. And now the hurricane is creeping north, slowly churning toward the Atlantic coast. The storm is losing strength, but it's still extremely dangerous. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jim Donovan.
And I'm Janelle Burrell. This is a live look at the surf in Daytona Beach, Florida. That area now under a hurricane warning, and the wind is expected to pick up as the day goes on.
Meanwhile, Hurricane Dorian continues to pound the Bahamas this noon with wind, rain, and a storm surge. Dorian is now a Category 2 storm with top winds of 110 miles per hour. It's responsible for at least 5 deaths.
Forecasters say it has been sitting over Grand Bahama Island for more than a day. Right now, it's moving at just 2 miles per hour.
As correspondent Hillary Lane reports, Florida, Georgia, and the Carolinas are bracing for Dorian's fury, hoping it remains offshore.
New scenes from the Bahamas show the unprecedented damage Dorian left behind.
Please pray for us, everyone. Please pray for us.
Dorian stalled as a Category 5 storm, pounding the Abaco and Grand Bahama Islands with torrential rains and 220 mile per hour wind gusts. Storm surge swallowed entire neighborhoods and left the airport runway under 6 feet of water.
As you can tell, we are going to need a lot of support.
This woman says her 8-year-old grandson drowned.
How am I supposed to feel? My grandson dead. I just seen my grandson about 2 days ago. My grandson just tell me he loved me.
Dorian's next stop, the U.S. coastline. An estimated 4 million people have been ordered to evacuate from Florida to North Carolina.
Oh, the water's getting closer. It's getting higher. Oh, yeah.
Many of the restaurants here in Daytona Beach are closed, and most of the buildings have been boarded up ahead of the storm.
But power crews are hunkering down. At the Daytona Speedway, 5,000 power trucks are parked, waiting to repair damage Dorian is expected to bring. Hillary Lane, CBS News, Daytona Beach, Florida.
And we are here with Katie in the Weather Center. Katie has a look at where Dorian is moving as it makes that slow march up the East Coast.
Yeah,
Katie.
So still hasn't actually made that exact right-hand turn that we're calling for, but it will, and it's just so slow. I think that may end up being one of the biggest legacies that this storm leaves behind because, yes, it's very strong, and even though it is losing its categorization, it's just been pummeling these exact same areas over and over. So here's a look at the most up-to-date track from the National Hurricane Center. As we mentioned, this storm has, in fact, been downgraded. Now it is a Category 2, so no longer a major hurricane, but a Category 2 nonetheless, meaning that you're dealing with these max sustained wind speeds of 110 miles per hour. And at this slow progression, it is still going to be producing some intense storm surge and flooding, and, of course, the wind damage that will come along with all of that. Eventually, as it makes that right-hand turn, it will start to interact with the United States coastline. There hasn't been a ton of shift in where this is expected to make a landfall, rather still right along somewhere within the Carolina coastline, very likely South Carolina, and then it'll make its closest pass to us heading into the tail end of the week. So we may see some of the outer bands of this storm as early as Thursday, but especially Friday, it looks like it'll make its closest pass and bring with it the best opportunity for us, if you want to call it that, the most likely opportunity, I should say, for us to see any showers and strongest winds out of this. Current alerts, tropical storm watches, warnings, hurricane watches, warnings lining that southeast coastline out into Lake Okeechobee as well with a tropical storm watch. So this does obviously have some impact inland as well. When you look at the kind of rain amounts you're talking about here, even just inland, there could easily be up to an inch plus worth of rain from this storm system, even though technically the storm will be offshore for Florida for the better part of that time frame. But the core of the heaviest rain obviously going into South Carolina as it currently stands. And of course, this has been a storm that has produced some curveballs, I guess we could call them here. So we're going to keep a close watch on it, and I'll also have the rest of our local forecast later in the broadcast. Jim?
Thank you, Katie.